beginning. We all come to a story with hopes and expectations, looking for an answer. Sometimes it would be better to live with that hope without ever knowing the full story. In a horror story, there are only victims and monsters. And the trick is not to end up as either. But trapped by the genre, we are all ripped to pieces along the way. This is not the story I hoped it would be. This is not the ending I wanted. This story will eat us alive. This story is a monster. And monsters wear many faces.
kiddo. How are you?
I'm good, Mom. How are you?
This trip might take a little longer than I thought. I'm sorry I've been gone so much lately, Logan.
Oh my God, Mom, it's not your fault. People get all murdery. What happened?
Just work stuff.
Right. Well, Dad and I are just watching the latest episode of Night Springs here. Mom, it's so good.
No spoilers! I'll let you get back to the show. You were supposed to wait and watch with me. I love you both.
This is what happens when you go on work trips, Mom. Love you too. And say hi to Casey. Tell him to stop brooding so much.
Logan? I will. Bye, kiddo. Logan thinks you should try cheering up.
Snarky kid. Wonder where she gets that from.
It can't be a coincidence that another body turns up just as we arrive in town. Feels like the killer's leaving us a message.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. It's right up your alley. You should take lead. Think of me as the backup.
Okay. Any words of advice?
Nothing that would cheer anyone up. Here we are, Cauldron Lake.
Time to get to work. A deputy was supposed to be here to show us to the crime scene. There's the car, so where's the deputy?
Eaten by a bear? I'll check out that map.
I think I hear someone. Could be our deputy.
I can go take a look.
Hey, over here. Hey there. Agent Casey, right? Sheriff Breaker said you'd be coming by to take over the case.
You're half right. Anderson?
Saga Anderson. I'll be leading this case. Seems you already know my partner, Alex Casey.
Shoot. Sorry about that, ma'am. I'm Deputy Mulligan. I just figured that, you know, that,
Where are those damn feds gonna show up, Mulligan?
Federal agent's right here, Thornton. My partner, Thornton. Down at the crime scene. He's not what you call the sharpest axe in the shed.
Right here? What do you mean? Are they with you? Oh, shit! They didn't hear me, did they?
What can you tell us about the crime scene?
Tell them about the heart.
I was getting to that, Thornton.
Well, we reckon there are some, organs that are currently outside the victim's person. When they should be, well, you know, inside.
Were there any witnesses?
Yeah, a couple out-of-towners.
I wonder what they were doing sneaking around the woods at night.
Mention the city folk. It's pretty suspicious.
Not that we have anything against city folk, cried Thornton.
But don't worry. Sheriff Breaker took them back to town a while ago.
I want to see the body. How do we get there?
Oh, sure, that's real simple. Just through the hole in the fence, down the hill towards the lake, around the old convenience store. You can't miss it. Everything's been closed since the area was fenced off. The store, the campground, all of it.
Hey, Mulligan, tell them I'm here, waiting. I'll show them around.
They got it, Thornton.
Before we get to the crime scene, there's time to review the facts of the case so far. Make sure I'm seeing the clues clearly. The Mind Place. My version of the Mind Palace technique. To sift through clues and work the case. Building the Mind Place again for each case. Using each field office as a model in my head. The facts are on the board. Everything we know about the previous murders. Worth taking another look.
I see you're already hard at work, Anderson. Close to cracking it?
We're just getting started. Let's head down the hill to the crime scene.
Fucking nature. Gives me a headache. There's too much sky.
Hey, Casey. You putting me in charge. Why now?
Look, Anderson, you're a better detective than I am. You've cracked cases that had the rest of us baffled. I don't want to slow you down.
Are you thinking of retiring? You know what happens to cops who say this is their last case.
Mm-hmm. Real funny, Anderson.
Stairs are out. You okay to jump down?
I'm not that old.
Not a bad place to get murdered.
If getting back to nature is your thing.
Damn. Should have brought an umbrella.
I like the rain. The only thing around here that feels like home.
You think the local law had the sense to put up a tarp?
If they did, next coffee's on me.
Deputy Thornton, I take it.
That's me, at your service, ready to get this case solved. Now the body's behind the store. Come on, I'll show you. So, FBI, huh? That's so cool. Hunting down psycho serial killers and shootouts with the mob.
You forgot the UFO cover-ups.
What? Those are real? You guys hiring?
Thornton, he's joking.
Let's just see this body, shall we?
Now Now, this is the scene of the crime. We found him on the table. Now, he didn't touch nothing. You know, procedures and stuff.
Thanks, Deputy.
No tarp. You owe me a coffee.
Okay. Let's start by examining our guest of honor. Does this fit the MO of the previous murders? Body is positioned on the table. Ritualistic. Another body turns up just as we arrive in town. Coincidence? Incised stab wound. Chest cut open. Heart removed. Bruising on the wrist from the cargo straps holding him down. The killer left the heart right next to the body. Heart removed from chest, strapped by the wrists. Definitely matches the previous murders. But this time the heart and the straps were left behind. More clues to work with. This makes four murders that we know about. Who is our victim? Who killed him? Need to find more clues. Large amount of blood on the table. The victim died here. Multiple people were here. Multiple killers? Someone was drinking beer. They spent time here. Waiting. Someone left in a hurry. Knocked the tripod over. Was it for a camera? Boot prints, indicating multiple killers. Quite the party. A creepy twig sculpture? I'm gonna go check something out. Be right back.
Got it.
Hey there, Mr. Deer. You remind me of a dream I had.
Anderson. Hey, let's get back to work over here, can we?
Hello, this is Agent Anderson and Agent Casey, FBI. We'd like to come in and ask a few questions pertaining to an investigation. Nice talking to you, too. Is that a kid's lunchbox? An Alex Casey movie lunchbox. Casey hates the endless jokes about coincidentally having the same name as a fake detective. He hates those cheesy crime books, but he really hates the movies. They left a lot of garbage. Not the fastidious type.
Welcome back, Anderson.
Any idea who the victim is?
Oh, I sure do. His name is Nightingale. He was FBI. He came to town about 13 years ago. I haven't heard a word about him since. Well, until now.
Nightingale? Robert Nightingale?
Oh, yes. You probably knew him. Brothers in arms. Oh, and sisters.
So you knew our victim?
Well, I didn't recognize him in his current state. But yeah, I ran into him a few times at Quantico. Never worked any cases together. After his partner got killed in the field, he went off the deep end. Got the boot pretty quick after that.
So what happened to Nightingale after the Bureau let him go?
I only know the rumors. Depression led to booze, booze led to paranoia. He got some wild ideas in his head, chased ghosts until he fell off the map. Guess he ended up here.
I bet there's more to that story.
But no happy ending.
Nightingale went missing 13 years ago, 2010.
The same as all the other victims.
Certainly fits the pattern. Makes me wonder what was going on that year.
Probably something this town wants to forget.
I think that's everything. For now, at least.
Mm-hmm. Anything clicking yet?
Not sure. Need to think about it. Robert Nightingale, ex-FBI, came to Bright Falls 13 years ago. They planned for the murder to happen here, passing the time with equipment ready. They were waiting for him. But why Nightingale? He's been missing for 13 years. Why here? Why now? Profiling. Get into the subject's head. See what they saw. Feel what they felt. Use whatever I know about them to guide my intuition to a revelation. Piece it together. Agent Nightingale has been MIA for 13 years. How did he end up here?
Up from the lake that's not a lake. It's dark. He was there too. You are not allowed in the lake until he says otherwise.
Robert Nightingale came from the lake before his murder. Nightingale was chosen as the victim. Why?
Click the switch. It goes click. Lights are off. But somebody's home. Somebody's home.
This wasn't some random act of violence. This was a ritual. And Nightingale a component. They didn't see him as a person. More like a container for something. Finding a Casey movie lunchbox out here can't be a coincidence. Another message? Doesn't look right. The lake is connected to Nightingale somehow. Casey, Let's take a look down by the lake. Lead the way.
Sounds good. This way, right?
Right.
Well, okay. Well, I'll just wait here.
This one of your hunches, Anderson? Did something happen at the lake?
I think Nightingale came up from that direction. From the lake. Probably looking for shelter. Safety. They were waiting for him.
When you're ready, I'd love to hear what you put together so far.
Sure. It's not that complicated. Nightingale was out in the woods alone at night, possibly nude. The killers knew he was here, ambushed him, dragged him to the campgrounds, strapped him to the table, cut his heart out. But then they were interrupted by those witnesses, the Bookers. The job is unfinished.
That seems pretty complicated to me. What was this guy doing skinny dipping at this time of year?
Haven't figured that part out yet.
Mm-hmm. Lots of questions.
Lots of answers for us to find.
I didn't know trees got that big. Gives me the creeps.
You need to get out more. It is kind of creepy, though. Tracks. Barefoot. Nightingales? They come out from under the boulder.
Makes no sense.
There's a piece of paper on the ground. A page full of text on one side. Not a printout. Written with a typewriter. Old school. Lines scratched out and edits added with a pen.
Mm-hmm. Like a manuscript. Page of a story. The killer left a message.
It's for us. The text is about us. The victim was one of their own. FBI Special Agent Robert Nightingale. And then there was the page they found. The first step down into terrifying depths.
Reading the words. These words
felt like a message.
Someone knew they were here. Someone playing a game with them. An invitation. How could they not accept?
Even if they knew it would end up hurting them. Someone's been watching us.
Playing a sick game with us.
You were right. This is right up my alley. Nightingale came this way. Either he dropped this page, or the killers left it for us. I think he came from the lake. But his tracks make no sense. We found a page in the woods. A story about these events. What is Nightingale's role in this?
I carry his words close to my chest now. Inside. The awful truth. You must dig it out.
Something was put inside him. In his chest. I must find out what. Found all I can here. Time to properly examine the body. See what I can find inside. Casey. I think something's been put inside Nightingale's body. Let's tell the deputies to get the body to the town morgue.
Okay.
Did you know this entire area is inside a caldera? This whole mountain used to be an active volcano. Imagine the force it took to carve this crater out of the earth. Caldera's are pretty rare, so be sure to take it in.
So, essentially, we're standing in the gaping maw of hell.
You got it. I used to love geology when I was in school. I helped Logan build a great baking soda volcano for her science fair.
Cheating on a science fair? That's almost a crime, Anderson.
I'm not gonna say no to quality time with a volcano. Hey, I mean my daughter.
You made it back. Good. I hope you didn't get stuck in any of those big puddles. Crazy flooding down there, huh? Just like I said.
Deputy, I want the body taken back to town for a proper examination ASAP.
Well, sure, but the coroner won't be back in town for another week after Deerfest.
Not a problem. I'll do it myself.
Oh, and Sheriff Breaker called to say he's got the bookers at the O'Deer Diner in town. Oh, and I've got a key to the gate. It's a shortcut back to the parking lot just up the hill.
Thanks. Let's get the car, drive to Bright Falls, and talk to these witnesses, the bookers.
At the diner, right? I could use a cup of coffee.
Let's try that shortcut the deputy mentioned.
Sounds good.
Seems like a nice town so far. Murders aside. Pretty woods. Cute lodge we got set up in. We should go for a hike if we get a chance.
Now you're just being mean, Anderson.
Deputies aren't exactly up to the task, but hopefully the sheriff will be more helpful.
Not a surprise about the deputies. Doubt they see much stuff this gruesome.
Can't fit the clues all together yet. Heart removed, tripod, tracks leading to a dead end.
A tripod? For a camera? To record a snuff film?
Maybe. And why take out his heart just to throw it away?
To stuff in something.
I think I saw something. It'll only take a minute.
I'll wait here.
Here we are. Let's drive back to town and meet the sheriff at the diner. I can't get that manuscript page out of my head. I've never seen killers reach out so directly before.
Damn impressive work so far. With your technique, these hunches were moving fast.
I wasn't sure about taking a case so far from home, but I'm thrilled to be here for this mystery. Need to swing by the lodge to get anything from the field office?
No, I'm all set.
I'll park there anyway. I want to walk to the diner, get a feel for the town.
Thank you.
The diner's just up the waterfront. Shouldn't keep the sheriff and our witnesses waiting.
I smell coffee.
Just how much coffee have you had today, Charlie?
Don't know, don't care. How much have you had? Not enough. Not so much. Never enough.
Oh, dear. Cute.
Let me guess. The FBI. Welcome to Bright Falls. It's nice to have you here. I got you both some coffee. Oh, it's Washington's finest.
Nice to meet you, Sheriff. I'm set for coffee.
You know, I wouldn't say no to another.
I'm Agent Saga Anderson. This is Agent Alex Casey.
Tim Breaker. And let me just say, I'm happy you two are here. Frankly, we could use the help.
Your deputies said you had a couple of witnesses here.
They made them sound like suspects.
Mulligan and Thornton are still on about that? No, no, the Bookers don't strike me as the murdering type, but you can decide for yourselves. They're just inside having coffee and pie to calm their nerves.
I'll see what they have to say. Casey, you compare notes with the sheriff.
Take your time. We've looked through the case files you sent over, Sheriff. Have you had many people besides the known victims go missing?
Sure.
Excuse me.
What?
I'm Agent Saga Anderson. Are you the Bookers?
That's us. I'm Tammy, and he's Ed.
Hello, officer.
Just Saga is fine, Ed.
So, are we being charged with anything? Because if not, we'd love to get back to our hotel and decompress after what we saw. Take a bath, scream into pillows, that kind of thing.
We're not charging you. I just have a few questions. Nothing to stress about, okay? What were you doing at Cauldron Lake last night?
I'm a writer. True crime. We're here from New York, doing some research on a famous novelist, Alan Wake, who went missing here. I was down at the lake, getting some details. Perfectly legal.
So what did you see in the woods?
This naked dude came out of the lake, and he was acting crazy, shouting weird shit at us. He must have been on something.
Unless skinny dipping at dawn is a thing around here.
Then we heard shooting. We ran into these psychos in deer masks. They were tearing into the naked guy with knives, like some kind of satanic cult. And then we bolted and called the cops.
What makes you say it was a cult?
The masks and knives aren't enough.
They were shouting, cult of the tree, the cult of the tree, cult of the tree. Oh, and then we found it. The whole thing was terrifying. That's all.
The Bookers were at Cauldron Lake. Why?
The fence was built to hide what's there. They say the rider fell in the lake.
Private party. No trespassing.
My book has questions. Pass the bolt cutters.
They broke in for the sake of Tammy's book. Nothing to do with a murder. They were telling the truth. The cult of the tree. What aren't the Bookers telling me?
I found their necklace. The symbol is two triangles.
The cult wants their spruce tree back. Tammy.
Finders keepers, Ed. My publisher will want this on the cover.
Tammy found something. A necklace belonging to one of the cultists. So you found something there, right? A necklace these cultists may have dropped.
Okay. Wow. How did you put that together?
It's evidence. You need to hand it over.
Told you not to keep that thing, Tammy.
Thanks. This could prove to be helpful. Do me a favor. Stick around town for now in case we have any more questions.
Like we'd even dream of missing Deerfest.
Oh, God. Anderson, as I live and breathe. I thought we'd never see you back here after that awful, awful thing happened to your baby girl. How are you? I'm sorry. Who are you? I don't know what you're talking about. It's me, silly. Rose. You know me. I don't think I do. And what horrible thing happened to my baby girl? She drowned. Your daughter. That's so weird you don't remember. How do you know I have a daughter? Oh, I know what this is. You're blocking out your traumatic memories. Happens on TV all the time. No. You're mistaking me for someone else. If you say so.
Good to see you.